Bulk actions allow users to perform a single operation, such as deleting, updating, or moving, to multiple selected items at once. They streamline workflows and improve efficiency, and they're necessary for applications that deal with viewing and editing large data sets. However, poorly designed bulk actions frustrate users, and they slow down their workflow. In this video, we'll cover three essential tips for designing bulk actions in table-based UIs and what to avoid. The first design guideline is to always provide a select all option in the top left corner of the table header, along with individual checkboxes in each row. This gives users the flexibility to quickly select each item in the table, select only those that they need, or deselect items. When only some items in the table are selected, use a visual cue to differentiate them from the rest of the table items. Changing the background fill or border of the row, along with adding a visual cue in the header row select all checkbox. That will alert users that some items are selected. You'll want to avoid making users hunt for the select all functionality on the page, and even worse, hiding the checkboxes to select and deselect items. Next, put bulk actions in a contextual menu that displays relevant actions to users after they've selected items. This action bar should appear only after they've selected items and include only the actions that are available. For example, if a user selected 5 items that are able to be deleted but not edited in bulk, include the delete function but not the edit function in that contextual menu. While fine for touch interfaces, avoid placing the contextual menu at the bottom of the screen. This functionality is easily missed on a web or desktop interface. Instead, place it at the top of the table or as a sticky menu that follows the user as they scroll. Our third design guideline is to always provide users with appropriate feedback, along with the option to undo actions to help prevent errors. For actions that are permanent, prompt users with a confirmation dialog with a clear message so that there's no ambiguity of what they're about to do. Immediate feedback after the action is completed, such as a toast message or alert, provides that visual cue that their actions were successful. For critical actions, such as permanent deletion or major edits, an undo option within that success message is a good safeguard in case the action was done in error. Avoid jumpy or jarring updates to the table, which can be disorienting to users. Subtle animations and success messages will help prevent confusion. By following these design guidelines, you'll make it easier for users to edit and delete table rows in bulk. For applications with large datasets, this functionality is essential for a smooth and productive experience.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, inninggroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live hands-on UX training.